Hi, my name is Annika, and I'm a second-year student studying electrical engineering at the University of Colorado Boulder. Today, we're going to learn about muscles. What do you think about astronauts? Astronauts get to do all sorts of amazing things. How would you like to visit the International Space Station, go on a spacewalk, or look down on planet Earth from outer space? That'd be pretty cool, right? Astronauts have pretty incredible jobs, but they're also tough ones. One of the numerous challenges that astronauts face is to identify and accommodate for the many effects that outer space has on their health. One effect is muscle atrophy, which means that when astronauts are away from Earth in a microgravity environment for a long time, their muscles become smaller and much weaker. Essentially, this means that muscles shrink. This is because in outer space, there's very little gravity, so hardly any force or load pulls down on the astronaut's muscles. On Earth, we have to constantly resist the force of gravity every day, which helps to keep our muscles working and strong. But in outer space, the astronauts don't have to resist gravity, so their muscles get weaker and eventually atrophy. According to researchers, after just 5 to 11 days in space, astronauts can lose up to 20% of muscle fibers. That's a lot of loss. What do you know about muscles? Do you know that every person has three different types of muscles in their body? The first type of muscle is called cardiac muscle. These are the muscles in your heart. The second type of muscle is called smooth muscle. These muscles line your stomach and other internal organs. The third type of muscle is skeletal muscle. The muscles are attached to your bones and help you move around. Skeletal muscles are the ones you can see when you flex your arm or leg. Skeletal muscles are also the only muscles that you can move by thinking about them. We call skeletal muscles voluntary muscles because you can volunteer to move them whenever you want to activate them. Cardiac and smooth muscles are involuntary because they move without you thinking about them. We know that if you reduce the loads or weight on your muscles, they will shrink and get weaker. But the great thing about muscles is that once you put weight on them again, they will begin to grow stronger. That is what happens when a person lifts heavy weights, for example, a weightlifter. Their skeletal muscles react to the repetitive lifting and eventually get stronger. So the very best thing that astronauts can do to keep their muscles strong is to exercise. The type of exercise that astronauts do is very important. It has to be resistance exercise, which means it has to create a load on their muscles. But exercising is tricky in outer space. Remember, there's very little gravity, so if an astronaut tried lifting weights, they would feel incredibly light and take little effort to lift. Therefore, how do astronauts get the exercise they need? Engineers at NASA have developed special machines to help astronauts create a load on their muscles, even in microgravity. Even though you may not be an astronaut, you can learn from their example. When people on Earth get older, their physical activity often slows down and their muscles begin to atrophy also, just like in outer space. So if you want to have strong, healthy muscles when you get old, you need to put loads on your muscles and exercise, just like the astronauts. Today we're going to learn about muscles and how engineers help keep astronauts' muscles healthy and strong in space. How would you dance, write, or smile without your muscles? You couldn't. It would be impossible. Muscles are in charge of all the body's movements. About 40% of the weight of the body is muscle. Some muscles get their instructions from the nervous system, which sends electrical impulses to the muscles telling them to move. However, your heart, which is made up of cardiac muscle, can contract all by itself without directions from the brain. Muscles get their energy from glucose that is carried in blood cells through the body. The body also stores glucose in the muscles as glycogen. Then, when you exercise, the glycogen is broken down to provide energy. Muscles are made up of fibers. The more a fiber contracts, the shorter the entire muscle becomes. The fibers consist of bundles of myofibril, which contain two types of filaments, called myofilaments. Thin filaments, primarily made of actin protein, and thick filaments, primarily made of the myosin protein. These myofilaments are bundled together to create myofibrils. These myofibrils are then bundled together to create a skeletal muscle fiber. When a muscle is stimulated, an actin protein travels over the muscle fiber membrane and causes a contraction. In a contracted state, the actin filaments are pulled inward among the myosin filaments so that the filaments can overlap each other. Do you remember what the three types of muscles are? The three different types of muscles are skeletal muscle, smooth muscle, and cardiac muscle. Of these, only the skeletal muscles are controlled by conscious thought. These muscles are visible on the outside of the human body, arranged in parallel bundles and attached to bones by tendons. Some of the skeletal muscles are the largest and most powerful muscles in the human body. Skeletal muscles include ones located in arms, legs, neck, tongue, and face. Tendons are located wherever there are skeletal muscles, helping to make a powerful movement team by attaching the muscles to bone. The smooth muscles make up hollow internal organs, which include organs such as blood vessels, the gastrointestinal tract, and the bladder. They use much less energy than the skeletal muscles and do not require conscious thought to make them work. Try telling your stomach to contract. The speed of smooth muscle contraction is much slower than the skeletal muscle. The cardiac muscle is the muscle that makes up the walls of the heart. Unlike the skeletal muscle, the heart takes a lifetime to tire. It pumps blood through the entire body continuously. Blood carries oxygen, and the cardiac muscle needs continuous, unobstructed oxygen to keep it alive. So when a heart attack occurs and blood stops flowing, the cardiac muscle rapidly dies. Let's review the different kinds of muscles. Who can remember what a smooth muscle is and give us some examples? Smooth muscles make up hollow internal organs, like the bladder or stomach. What about skeletal muscles? Skeletal muscles are attached to the bone that you can see when you exercise. And who can remember the third type of muscle? The third muscle type is cardiac muscles. These are the muscles in the heart. Which of the three muscle types is voluntary, meaning you can move them by thinking about them? The answer is skeletal muscles. Skeletal muscles are the only voluntary type of muscle. Other muscles are involuntary since we cannot control the contraction of our stomach and heart, for example. Engineers need to understand how the human body works in order to help astronauts stay healthy in outer space. The microgravity of outer space leads to muscle shrinkage, and so scientists and engineers at NASA work to design special exercise machines to help the astronauts maintain muscle strength during spaceflight. Check out the lesson on the Teach Engineering website and then apply what you learned about muscles in our associated hands-on activities. Walk, run, jump, and muscles everywhere.